to another edition of Pittsburgh Sportsline at Sips Sports Bar, 3024 West Liberty Avenue, Pittsburgh, PA. That's actually Dormont, 15216. Thanks for watching us on Verizon 32 everywhere in the Pittsburgh area, only Comcast 7 in Bethel Park, and on Pittsburgh Sportsline on Facebook. Devin, what's the latest count? 3,048? Thanks to everybody for liking us. Anybody that's new that hasn't liked us, maybe we can get 3,050 today. And thanks, Smoking Jim, for spreading the word out there. Jillian, if you're on Facebook, like Pittsburgh Sportsline.
I already have.
There we go. That's our waitress here. We have a great day in sports. Matter of fact, we're watching the U.S. beat Ghana right now in soccer. How cool is that? All right, we're going to start our show off. I'm Al Levine, the talking machine. Smoking Jim Frazier. Zach Brenner, little Z's on his way. He's en route. We'll see if he can make it today. We have a lineup of some great guests. And we're going to start with what's on our mind right now. Hey, Smoking Jim Frazier, what's on your mind?
Hey, thanks, Al Levine, the talking machine. And if you want the green...
Whoa, where's that pen?
You got to see Levine. Hey, I want to please everybody give a big hand for all the fathers in here. Happy Father's Day. Special happy Father's Day to LeBron James. Now he got the whole offseason to work on those cramps. Listen, I won heavy money by predicting before the series that the Spurs would win in five. Everybody also knows that I won heavy money on the Super Bowl where Peyton Manning in Denver, I haven't seen a slow white Bronco like that since O.J. Simpson. Happy 20-year anniversary, O.J. In June of 1994, smooth Johnny Cochran convinced everybody that nobody could be that stupid. No one man could make all those many mistakes. Nobody could leave a bloody glove at the crime scene, another bloody glove at the house, all while dripping blood up and down Rockingham Boulevard, blood in the grass, blood in the bushes, blood on the outside of the slow white Bronco, blood on the inside of the slow white Bronco, climbed over the wall at his estate where he lived, where he had a key to the gate, knocked on the wall, woke up lazy Cato. I tell you what, OJ couldn't have committed all those crimes. The OJs couldn't have committed all those crimes. And afterwards, OJ wrote a book, If I Did It. If smooth Johnny Cochran is so smooth, he even got OJ believing he didn't do it. Hey, OJ, if you want to find out who committed all those crimes, look at the man in the mirror.
Thanks, Smoking Jim. You covered a lot of territory. And that heavy money sounds great, buddy. When are you buying a football team or basketball team? Maybe Miami will be for sale.
I'm buying a Hope Diamond for Lish.
Whoa. That's a guess. You don't want to introduce her yet. You are too much. I need a drink after that one. I got a couple things I want to promote first. John, am I still on that camera? If you could get a close-up on this Cribs for Kids. Dana Slizik was on our show last week talking about this great thing to help kids that die, you know, by SIDS. They'll die in their cribs. So they offer this program. It's been out there for a long time. They've been doing a lot of great work. And you can join that and fundraise for them and help, you know, these kids and find a cure for it. Some of it's just having a crib helps them out. Now, thank you on that. Now we have an event coming up where it's June 26th. If you could pull this up for a second. This is with Jessica Lee, Pittsburgh Sportsline with Smoking Jim Frazier, Al Levine, the talking machine, and Zach Brenner. We'll be there from 5:30 to 8. We'll be filming a special show there. at Enigma. Yes, Enigma on 7th, Smoking Jim. It's a brand new place on 7th Street, not far away from the bridge and where Bossa Nova was. So come on out. You can have some fun. There's going to be different specials, I'm sure drink specials. I got a couple guests. I'm about ready to announce who's going to be there. We got some special people in Pittsburgh that want to be on our show as a featured guest. And it's not the Aflac doll that you got. We get all kind of gifts. Last week, I got all the free T-shirts and hoodies. Smoking Jim come in, and Kamikaze Kid gave him the Heisman Aflac duck doll. So he's making out like a bandit. Well, now to sports. What's on my mind is the resurgence of the Pirates. And yes, one man has made a difference. And the other man who's made a difference is Kutch. He just won NL Player of the Week. I mean, the guy's on fire right now at the right time. We're getting some good pitching, although we haven't capitalized enough on it. We're still a game below 500, so I'm hopeful. I've had that Kool-Aid, and I'm hoping we can do well this year. They need another starting pitcher or two, but maybe they found their outfielder. They brought him up, and he's playing like a major leaguer. He has a 6-game hitting streak already, so Polanco's the real deal, and that's what's on my mind.
Well, I tell you what, I don't know how we got her to come here. I tell you what, she's a model, she's an actress, she's a businesswoman, and I tell you what, she got the best legs in Pittsburgh. Please put your hands together for supermodel, Lish Danielle.
Welcome to the show. Nice to see you.
Nice to see you too, fella.
Hold it, did you bring nice shoes for Smoking Jim?
Mm-hmm. Woo!
Like that?
Yeah. Oh, you got to get one shot of that.
Yay! How have you been?
Excellent. And great. Since you're a great interviewer, I'll start out. How are you?
I'm doing fantastic. So I have something to contribute to the Pittsburgh Sportsline in the sports area. I went to my first Pirate game last Wednesday, and yes, McCutcheon hit a home run
for
straight
you.
Out. I was so happy. There were fireworks. I was so excited.
Have you ever been to a Pirate game before?
I had not. I hadn't even been to PNC Park besides to walk around. It was
How
amazing.
How beautiful it is, huh?
It's amazing. I really was happy. I was a little scared, though, because
why?
I'm afraid of heights, and it was steep.
Are you really?
In my seat. But I am.
You survived.
I survived.
You're here tonight.
I'm courageous.
Yeah,
I'm not going to miss that over a fear,
sure.
Please.
Right, and you saw Kutch hit a home run.
It was amazing. I liked
that.
Did
they win the game? You
no,
didn't
we
stay.
Left. We left. We left early.
You pulled a Batwoman. Batman leaves early, so you're Batwoman.
That's what happened. It had been delayed because of rain. So I had to leave. It was like around 10:30.
Past your bedtime.
Past my bedtime.
I understand.
Beauty rest.
Well, we all need that. Well, I'm glad you could make it today.
I'm happy you have me on here. So many things to talk about. I've started a business. You know, I like to do that.
Yes.
This one, it's Hard Workers Incorporated. I am now developing talent.
How are you?
And promoting businesses, helping them gather their starting capital and helping people like Smoking Jim here.
Well, I heard you're partnering up with Smoking Jim this week or something.
He is the greatest man in the universe for co-hosting my event this Thursday, June 19th at the Pittsburgh Center for the Arts, Twisted at a Glance. I brought a little flyer.
Yay!
We're having a runway show. It's being put up
and
by...
What's the address? Where's that at?
Okay. Let me right here. Pittsburgh Center for the Arts. It's 6300 Fifth Avenue.
Okay.
Over in 15232, so that's Shady Side, and it's actually right at 5th and Shady. It's the big, gorgeous
there
yellow
we go.
Building you pass. And with your ticket, you get to look at the galleries as well as the actual show. We have four different designers: Markav Clothing, Terry Jolo, Unique Impressions, and Crown Royalty, all displaying their summer line.
And what time does it start?
Okay, doors open at 7 p.m.
Okay.
And then the show starts at 8 o'clock to 9:30. And then we're having an after party.
Any swimsuits that night?
I have to save that for the actual show.
He's trying to tip it off. This co-host is a little too anxious there.
I am just so happy that he'll do it with me. I'm excited.
He's the busiest man in media, but he makes time for you. That's awesome.
He really did. So, yeah, it's being the actual event is being put on by Twisted Runway LLC.
Okay.
The director is Ramirez Harp. And so also with the VIP ticket, you get the new album, Theatrics, by Ramirez Harp, right there.
That sounds great. Now, what's a ticket cost?
Ticket, right now, it's $30.
$30 for all that.
You get to look at the galleries. There are multiple performances throughout the actual runway show.
Okay.
Hula hoop artists, but oh yes, we got some lovely ladies who are dancing. There's a new crave called Yamaya.
I'm not familiar with that.
You have to come and get familiar, honey. You
goodness.
Have to come.
Really?
It's going to be so exciting. I mean, Jim and I are hosting, but I mean, we're just this much of the show. It's going to be great. VIP is for $45, and there's an after party sponsored by Click Vodka at a secondary location. That's the Art House in Highland Park. And just more performances, more mingling, great network for photographers.
Are you going to be doing any runway stints there?
Well, I was allocated an outfit from Crown Royalty. So I'll get to grace that while I host.
I thought maybe something would happen.
They give me clothes sometimes.
How about a nice suit for him?
Well, I need your sizes, honey. We need to get on this now. Come on.
Just go like 4X.
No. I'll make sure they like cut it out for like the muscles here and everything. Make room.
All right, 3X. Do I hear a winner there?
Stop. But no,
he's a big man in the city now. Come on.
He's a big man because he's everywhere.
Well, that too.
He's everywhere.
He has a physical presence, though.
That's wonderful.
Give him your sizes. You get free clothes, my friend.
We'll start
at least
four.
To wear them.
We'll start at 4X and work our way up.
No, say it ain't so. It can't be.
Jim's waistline aside.
And his chest side.
Segue.
Good segue out of that. It's getting a little.
It's really going to be great. Everyone has really been putting a whole lot of effort into the actual show. The venue has been donated to us by Joyce Otto, yes.
That's great.
So she believes in us. People are donating their time. Our gift bag is packed with goodies from all around the city. So you're definitely going to love it if you come.
How about Smoking Jim? Will he like his gift bag?
He's going to love his gift bag, and he gets me on his arm all night.
Don't say that.
I'm not going to discount. I'm pretty fly here. I know what I got going on.
Yeah, definitely. Okay.
I'm keeping letting the duck stay at home.
Whoa, leave the duck at home. Aflac.
Oh,
that's an unpaid commercial there. No doubt. No, it sounds like a super event.
It's going to be wonderful. So tickets, you can purchase them online. You can purchase at the door. But Twisted Runway Pittsburgh, that's actually twistedrunwaypgh.eventbrite.com. And you can purchase your ticket in advance. You don't have to worry about any lines. And then you actually have a physical receipt of your payment.
Sure.
So that's why we like to do it that way. twistedrunwaypgh.eventbrite.com.
There you go. Sure. Now, how do they get a hold of you for your business here?
How do they get a hold of me? Well, of course, I'm Lish Danielle. You can find me on Facebook at Lish Danielle Works. You'll see everything regarding Hard Workers Incorporated. If you want to book me or any of my models or get a consultation with me for your business, you can contact me at 412-721-4203. You better like that page. Yes. 412-721-4203.
I think I might have liked it already on Facebook.
You have. Have you been scarred?
No, I don't think I have. You just started this thing.
Oh, no. It's been up. I have a number of photo shoots. I do paid photo shoots, but I'm not representing any lines. Oh. So that's just something to say about the aesthetic of the actual page. Kids shouldn't be on there.
Right.
But
okay.
Other than that, you can see all of our businesses, all of our models, anyone I'm working with musically, anywhere. I was just at the Arts Festival performing last weekend.
Where were you? Mm-hmm. How did that go?
It was fun. It rained.
Well, you know, the art festival is traditional.
Every year.
Definitely.
And also last week was my birthday.
Happy birthday.
Yes, thank
I think
you.
I wish you a happy
yes,
birthday
on Facebook.
Yes, you did.
I had a wonderful time. It's my birthday month, so I had a birthday suit photo shoot in honor of me in June, and that'll be up by the end of the month.
That's
so everyone can celebrate
too.
With me. Really?
Yeah.
Cancer or Gemini?
Cancer, the last day.
Oh, you're my goodness.
You're a Gemini.
I'm a Gemini. Oh, that's
my.
Why I can handle doing way too much at one time.
Oh, really? Those two people handle it well.
Two people. Sometimes I feel like there's more.
Oh, no.
I'm not
be
crazy,
another
though.
Show.
I'm not crazy,
okay.
though.
I'm glad you said that. The good list.
The good list.
Now, where's that Lish Danielle?
Lish Danielle, right? Works.
That's
all
it.
Over it.
And how's that works thing going that you were doing?
I mean, we're doing a great job. We are representing three businesses. We have two event planning companies at the moment. One of my event planning companies is actually in Atlanta. There's going to be a fantasy hair battle royale hitting.
Really? What's that?
Okay, so.
At least explain it.
Of course. Well, so a fantasy hair battle is usually when hair designers and salons come together and they do crazy looks with added hair.
Okay.
And it's actually like a runway show. We're taking it to the next level. We're touring four major cities. That's Charlotte, North Carolina. That's August 16th. New York City, September 20th. We're going to St. Louis, Missouri. That's October 18th. And then we're going to be in Las Vegas, Nevada in November. We are raising money.
Is Smoking Jim going with you? Or are you
I
working
hope,
those details out?
I hope. I mean, we have to see how this first event works out.
Sure.
And as long as he's tame, I mean, I'm going to bring him everywhere.
Really?
Everywhere.
See, Smoking
I need
Jim.
Him. I need him. He doesn't realize how much he means to me.
Oh, my. This will be our after-hours show.
Stop. But, yeah, the fantasy hair battle, we're raising money for Susan G. Komen.
Oh, that's great.
Because it is a hair battle, but we want to bring attention to what people take for granted.
Sure.
Your crowning glory. I mean, you've got luscious locks and
oh,
very thick,
you.
Long eyelashes. But what would you do if something
you.
Happened that you lost them? You know?
I guess I'd shave my head.
You'd have to do it, but at one time you'd be like, oh no.
Yeah,
you know?
That's
so
true.
I'll be doing interviews with patients and physicians from the Hillman Cancer Center, and putting together just a nice tribute video
right.
to help bring awareness to it and raise some money for breast cancer.
Boy, that is awesome.
I told you I'm busy.
You are busy.
I'm
Plus, don't you
busy.
Have a day job too?
State Farm Insurance.
We have to at least
Grace Robinson. Promote. Yes, we are in the Pittsburgh Sportsline magazine.
That's it.
We'll right in the middle fold, hun, with the map. See, I know
where
exactly
where it is. I do too, but I'm a little slow on that.
Grace actually just celebrated 32 years in agency,
wow.
as well as 20 years in her nonprofit, Tomorrow's Future, Inc.
And that is fantastic.
Yes, I sang at the event, and to see all the love and support of the money that was raised for the continuance of the program.
She is a great person. We appreciate her advertising with us. And
mm-hmm.
You helping us out. You sent me to a few places in the neighborhood. They all took the magazine. So.
Okay, good.
Yeah.
So, we'll get them to buy ads next time.
I dropped your name like crazy.
Please do.
And they said what a nice person you are.
Oh, thank you.
And on
well,
that,
that's my
thanks,
mentor. Mm-hmm.
Thanks again.
Thank
we appreciate
you.
It.
Thank
good
you
luck
for having
to you.
Me.
Introduce yourself. It's been since last year since we had you on here.
All right, so Karen Hall, Hall of Fame, as I'm known to Hal Levine, the Talking Machine.
Always.
And Smoking Jim, former Mount Alvernia High School point guard, UNLV, Nevada, University of Nevada, Las Vegas, Lady Running Rebel, point guard, and whatever they needed me to be. Now head women's basketball coach at the Community College of Allegheny County, one of my many coaching stops around the country. So here to talk about our team and
let's just get right in.
Whatever else we want to talk about.
That's why we were hoping to get you in during the season, but you were so busy.
Well, season went pretty good. Actually, you know, you have goals to basically win it all, and you know, you have different ups and downs during your season, and we had numbers issues going up and down all year. So we actually made it to the conference championship. So that actually surpassed what I thought about our team. But That was a good thing.
Ah.
No, that's a good thing. I mean, you have injuries, and you know, you push 6-7 young women to the limits, and they sustain themselves, and you know, really committed themselves to what we were doing, and took us to a conference championship. Winning is the only thing I know, so there was just a little disappointment.
I sense a lot more than that
because
you're such a great competitor. We know that. So, we've had you on our show a couple times, even on our Tuesday night show.
That was fun.
You held your own with all the guys.
Well, I grew up with guys, so this is nothing new for me.
This is better odds. There's only two of us. On that show, there were three of us.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, but see, having more men, that's always a good thing for me.
Whoa.
Yeah, I mean, kind of like smoking gym with the young lady here. So
he's just in demand. He's in demand.
Yeah, I was pretty happy. But overall, the season went well.
What was the record?
14-6.
Pretty good.
That's not bad.
That's not bad. I mean, from where we've come, that's really good.
Yeah, tell us what the record was before.
I don't remember.
I think they even had a winning record.
I don't remember those things.
Oh, very good.
I'm a competitor.
Are you?
You know,
you're all about the W's. That's why we like you back here. Well,
yeah.
How were your players? Any standout players?
Well, actually, I had Taylor Smith, who actually was a conference first team. She was first team all conference.
Really?
That's great. So she's being recruited by Cheney University, and you know, looks pretty good for her to make her way down there to continue, you know, going to school and playing some college basketball. I have three other kids who need to finish up some credits to
earn their associates. That's good for you, because then they
got to stay. Well, they have to stay, but they've used all their eligibility.
I'm
really in the process of recruiting an entirely new team. So I guess that's the junior college thing, because it's like not one and done. But it's two and done. So,
how do they get a hold of you if somebody knows a great woman?
Okay,
women
so
basketball
if
player.
You know a great young woman who is a true student athlete, she has to go to classes. I'm not a micromanager, so she has to go to class, and she needs to be able to play basketball. So
that
the number
simple.
That is very simple.
They don't have to do that in North Carolina.
I didn't say that. The number is, please, 412-237-2533. And you can ask for Coach Hall, capital H-A-L-L, Coach Hall.
You can't make it any easier than that.
I can't. I mean, I'm not asking for much.
All those great athletes, contact Coach Hall.
Yeah, I mean, you know, it's an opportunity to play some basketball. It's college basketball, very seasoned head coach. I've been around the country. I've coached men and women.
Men too.
Yeah, of course I did.
You better tell me that story.
Well,
how did we miss that story?
Of course. Okay, so I got to start a little.
Go ahead. You better tell me.
So, can I mention the league?
Yeah.
Okay, so the Connie Hawkins, the Connie Hawkins Men's Summer Basketball League.
Okay.
So I was asked to play in the league when I was still in college, which I did, so I became the first woman to play in the league. So that was great, and it was just basketball to me. And then I was asked to coach in the league.
Those are men there.
Yes, basketball.
If you're the first woman, then it means everybody else is a man.
Exactly. But when I was asked, it wasn't truly to, they basically needed somebody else to coach. Is really what the deal was. However, I'm a competitor, so if you ask me to coach,
you wanna win.
All I know is one way. So,
although
it was a summer league, I got my guys. Of course, we were the Rebels, of course.
Why not?
Yeah, and
running Rebs.
And, you know, they just showed up to play. These were good players. Steve Vandeveer, Billy Varner, yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, yeah. I had him for 3 years. Andre Boyd, who was at Robert Morris at that time. Derek Gordon from Peabody. So I had, number one, they were good guys, first of all. And then they could all play. So that made me really excited about that. And, you know, I just coached them. I mean, they were showing up for a summer league.
Yeah.
I was showing up for my team.
And then what happened?
And then we took the league by storm. No one figured out that.
What year was this? I'm checking the record book.
I don't remember. It was mid-90s. Mid-90s.
You're too
I can give it. But we did. We were back-to-back Connie Hawkins Men's Adult Summer League Champions. Thank you.
Really? That is awesome. What a story.
And I was one 3-point shot that spun in and out, Darren Walls, from the left corner, spun in and out, or that would have been a three-peat.
A three-peat at the Connie Hawkins League.
Who beat you, the ranking gangster?
No, no, I'm not that far back.
Oh, he's trying to I know. Don't fall for that.
I'm not, but I can't because I wasn't that far back. Yeah, what year was that again, Jim? Smoking Jim.
Oh, he's not going to tell you. He's an honest man.
I won't tell you the year. I threw that in there. Yeah, so.
That was good.
Yeah, it was a great experience, and they're my guys. They'll always be my players. Actually, I have Steve Vandeveer, who is my present-day assistant at CCAC, and which is really good because the way I coach collegiate basketball is how I coach them, and he can really help the young women understand. It's coach, you know, this is how you do it. She does it.
Sure.
Just bring it, give it to her, and we go about our way. But I have to say, you know, collegiate experience for these young women and men around the country, they got to take advantage. I mean, one and done, I get it. I know why it happens. Right. However, they need to understand that, you know, you could be one and done in the pros because now you're injured. You might have a big contract, but, you know, there is life after the ball deflates.
Sure, and they need
They need to have something ready. You know, I think the guys, well, I know the guys back in the 80s, Magic Johnson, that whole era. I mean, obviously they were prepared because you look today and they're all doing great things in the community. They got businesses. They're creating jobs for people, period.
Rodman's going to North Korea.
Not again.
I just say that. That's a smoke gym.
We're not playing.
No, I'm not throwing that in there.
Yeah.
Yeah, so.
Well, what's your team look like for next year? Do you have any idea because of all
We're actually going to be better because I'm able to, I'm recruiting players. And, you know,
That's right up his alley.
We were a conference runner-up, which it's growth of the program, absolutely. So
who should we look for as a great player, up-and-coming player?
I can't tell you that. I need to come back on during the season. I mean,
you've given us so much information. I'm going to areas where you might have to shoot me then. You can't tell me.
Well, it's not a secret. I just need to make sure it is what it is.
Okay.
I mean, they're great players right now on paper.
Oh,
you know, it's the collegiate level, next level.
You're a businesswoman, too, on this.
Well, collegiate athletics is a business.
Yeah, that's why I'm
saying. So, absolutely.
Right.
And, you know, my business is all year round. It never stops, always promoting and recruiting and, you know, just trying to make things better for, you know, young women and give them opportunities.
Well, any way that we can help, you let us know and you come back on anytime you want.
Let me get that number one more time.
We're going to. How do you know? I'm hard of hearing. Tell me that number one more time.
Erico, 412-237-2533. CCAC Women's Basketball Head Coach, Coach Hall.
Excellent. Thank you very much. I appreciate it.
My name is Dan Kikuta, father of some awesome kids, grandfather of one awesome little kid as well. I do a little bit of fighting as well, picked up something over the weekend.
Let me see that belt now. You said you told me you were going to get the belt.
Yes,
I didn't doubt you. There were some other doubters out there. I don't know why.
They're always
just because Dan Bogan said you had to go fight his dog who conveniently retired.
But we've made our amends now. So
and then what's the explain good. To the folks what the belt's called?
It's the Gladiators of the Cage Amateur Middleweight Championship. It's for fighters at 185 pounds down to 171.
Wow.
And I just picked it up this weekend. I fought Brandon Lux, tough guy, great gentleman as well. We actually became friends afterwards. Actually got cool with each other even before we fought each other.
Right.
But
he was all dressed up from when he come in, wasn't he? Wasn't he the guy?
Actually, no, I didn't even see what what he's wearing when he walked in.
I think he was all dressed up there, and it was great to see him there. You put on quite a performance. We saw you
thank you.
Next to the cage. Uh-huh. We heard
best spot
the
in the house.
Kicks and the hits and everything else.
Uh-huh.
It was unreal.
Yeah,
you put on quite the performance there, my friend.
Thank you. I make effort to do that.
It was nice to see that. Let me just set that. Well, we can't. How about you just hold that right there?
You got to hold it and smile.
You got to just smile. Your job is to smile.
Be handsome. There you go.
I stink at smiling.
You stink at smiling.
Don't
let them know that.
Now, last week we didn't get a lot of time.
That's okay.
So I wanted to give you some time, and I'm glad you could bring your son. Now, everybody, like Jim Ajay, is an expert. Uh-huh. And he always asks people when they're done, what did you think of your fight? And I'm going to do the same thing because he's my mentor on this.
Okay.
And I always wonder, because I've been competitive, and I always thought I could do better, mm-hmm. even if I won, or no matter what sport, even team sports.
There were some things I wanted to do better in there, not necessarily in what I did. There were some things I was looking forward to doing in the fight that I just didn't have the time to do.
Right. Now, explain to the folks when the fight ended. Or
The fight ended, I finished it by arm triangle choke, which basically it's a choke that cuts off the blood supply to the brain. They can go out relatively quickly.
He was basically
quickly
unconscious, sir?
No, he wasn't. He tapped.
Just barely.
He tapped in time. Usually it's something that you can kind of sense it. And, you know, they freeze up a second before it happens, and they're like, it's time to
Because you're competitors.
Right, correct. Yeah, we want to last till the end, and some people have passed out due to it.
Right.
Fortunately, it didn't. And I was happy it actually ended that way because, like I said, Brandon Lux is a really good guy.
Didn't he go on short notice to come to your fight?
Was no, actually,
or he was already scheduled.
He and I were originally scheduled to fight against each other after we both fought in the last Gladiators of the Cage event.
Right.
This was in March 15th. So not the last one, but the one before that, March 15th. At that time, we both won our fights. We both went 3-0, but he had dropped down to a lower weight class to the 170 pound weight class, and he fought for a title last month. He ended up losing that decision. So decided to come back after 185, take another crack at it since the opportunity was still there for
you. You don't look 185.
I'm about 200 right now.
Are you serious? Yeah. The shape you're in.
Yeah, it's heavy bones.
You told me the last time.
Yeah, I put about, it's actually surprised myself, I put about 10 pounds back on
that
before
night.
I went to bed.
That night.
Wow.
Yeah. That's unusual for me.
Is it?
Yeah, felt good though.
Do you work out all the time?
Every day, almost every day.
And then the cut and weight. You'll
the
do
cut
that
weight,
a little, but not as much for you?
Not as much. I don't cut heavily. I lose about 10 to 15 pounds to fight. Normally, when I'm in top shape, I walk around about 195, anywhere from 195 to 200.
So you're comfortable with that?
I'm pretty comfortable. I never used to cut at all. I used to just fight wherever I was at.
Really?
I'd just be at the bottom of the weight class. And
I see this Muay Thai. Are you a Muay Thai fighter? Is that what you did first?
Predominantly. Okay. I started off doing regular full contact kickboxing. Then I moved on to boxing. I did that for about 8-9 years.
You were actually a boxer?
Yes.
Out of where?
Out of here in Pittsburgh. I fought...
What gym?
I used to train at Hogan's Gym down 8th Street.
Okay.
Before they closed down. Now they closed
a while
ago. Maybe over 10 years ago. Then I trained at Weight Masters out in Wilkinsburg, and that gym's closed a few
where
years
Rayco
ago.
Where Rayco wore Saunders.
Rayco Saunders. Yeah, he and I used to spar all the time. We used to train with the same
Can
trainer.
Can you believe he's a
Weaver.
Vegetarian?
Get out of here. Rayco? Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know when that was. He might have been all along. I don't know.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Well, you didn't
Rick
see
was a man of few words.
Punch.
Yeah, we were in the ring throwing punches at each other. But
yeah.
We both trained under the same trainer, Tink Weaver. And I trained with Eddie Chambers Sr., who was the father of Fast Eddie Chambers, back when they lived here. They were the guys.
Cutie Pie Chambers.
He's still a good friend
I'm
of mine.
I'm surprised you didn't run into Smoking Jim Frazier.
I might have. Back then, I had dreadlocks.
That's
a big difference.
Did you?
Yeah.
Maybe you saw him boxing.
Had dreadlocks and cornrows back then.
Oh, yeah.
You probably did.
Yeah, Eddie and I used to, we were really good friends. Big Eddie and I still stay in contact with each other.
Wow.
They're down in Florida now. And, I stay in touch with him. We talk from time to time.
Yeah.
See how things are going with his family and whatnot.
Sure.
Little Eddie and I probably haven't talked for a while. But, still good friends of mine. I still, care about them.
Where are you from in Pittsburgh?
I live on the west end over by Crafton.
I grew up in Greentree, so
okay,
I know where we're
right close
is.
By. My kid, actually, he goes to Westwood Elementary.
Yeah.
Out in Greentree.
You mean first grader?
I didn't say what grade you were. I said what school you were. But yeah, he had to check me on that since he's out of kindergarten now.
I'd like to correct you every time.
Of course, he's got to correct me every time. He's a know-it-all. He's the genius. He's the genius. I'm not.
You keep fighting so he can come on the show.
Exactly.
Again.
He's got to represent me.
Ron, how do they get a hold of you? Do you have a fan page? Or?
Actually, I don't have a fan page yet. People have been telling me I need to put one up, but I'm just like, I don't.
You might now after a belt.
Yeah. Yeah, and I really do need to just for the marketing side of it.
Well, here, tell them. Your nickname. There.
Okay, my nickname is, I have no nickname, honestly.
What's
my
his name, bionic
The
fist?
Bionic Fist of Justice came about, it was actually a nickname I made for my hand. Just because after the first surgery, there was a possibility of needing to put a plate in there.
And wow. Actually,
the second time I broke my hand, they did put a plate on the back to protect my knuckle, or to protect the bone that I originally snapped the first time.
Wow.
But the Bionic Fist of Justice was just a nickname I made up for my hand.
Dan Bogan keeps promoting that.
Well,
yeah,
he likes it. He likes it. I guess it works. You know, I could probably make a comic book out of it or something. But
you might be able to.
I just go
in there. Make sure you get Dan Bogan on.
Well, I'll make him a villain.
That's what I'm saying. A villain. You're the good guy. He's evil.
And Samson will be a cyborg subordinate.
I like what you're talking about. And this is the type of stuff that you see that we promote here on MMA. Look, he has a son here. He does a lot of great things. And he's a nice guy here. But not in the ring.
No, I'm a nice guy.
Not in the cage.
I'm a nice guy in the ring.
I saw
too,
in the cage. He's a gentleman and he's a true sportsman.
In the cage is business. Can I say one thing, please?
Sure, go ahead.
I forgot to say it, even though I had a really long thank you speech on Saturday. But there was still something I forgot to mention. And I felt terrible about it afterwards. I mentioned two of my kids. I have a daughter. She's 22 years old. Her name is Taylor. She's my stepdaughter, actually. Okay. But I felt terrible about the fact that I didn't mention her. Then I kind of got sidetracked.
We'll say hi to her tonight. This will be rebroadcast.
Hey, Taylor, baby girl. I love you. And I had to go and apologize to her about it, too. She's 22. Sure. She's going through nursing school right now, working her butt off to take care of her young son, who's 2 years old, young Mason, my grandson.
Nice.
Wanted to invite everybody to go visit her. She works over at Grill 36, Jerome Bettis's. She was right across the street from Stage AE. She was working that night, which is the reason she couldn't be there when I was fighting.
Sure.
But that's all. I just want to say how much I love her as well. And
she's been
my daughter since she was 7 years old.
You got to do it here on Pittsburgh Sports.
Yes, sir. Thank you. Thanks for the opportunity.
Thanks for coming back.
Yeah,
I appreciate
it.
Jameson, we're going to have a little speech for you next time, so then you can just go by that.
Okay.
All right.
What do you want to say? You want to say hi to anybody? Anybody.
Well,
pick
somebody
up. I'm
going to mention my nephew.
Right now?
Go ahead.
Right now.
Like, my nephew is like Mason.
Camera.
He's 2 years old. I love him so much. And
That's it.
All right.
He's the man.
I'm knocking off.
And that's it. Oh, man, this is one of my newest.
The champ is here.
One of my newest MMA fighters. He just was fantastic on Saturday night. Introduce yourself, and we'll just go from there, my friend. Welcome back.
Thank you. My name is John Rarick. What else you want me to say? No, I'm 12 years old. If you didn't know.
Hold it. Wait. Let me do the disclaimer. Last week you had 2 minutes, and I was asking how old he was. And I said, you look like 18. He goes, no, I'm 12 years old.
They let me drink beer at 12 years old now, so I'm happy.
No, not here at Sips. They carded him twice.
He said six.
But seriously, he's like a baby-faced assassin here.
Little ones are the ones you got to worry about.
And I'm worried. I saw him in the cage. What a match you had there.
Yeah.
Definitely. You want to tell us a little bit about it?
I went in there really not knowing much about the guy, honestly. So I was like, I was real nervous.
And you haven't fought in a while.
I haven't fought since November. I was supposed to fight in Johnstown, but they had another 12-year-old that just didn't want none, you know.
I understand.
It's just how it works.
12-year-olds are like that.
But I was supposed to fight in Johnstown, so I got ready for this fight. And just came out hungry, really. That's all
and
it
what
was.
And what weight class were you at?
We fought at 140. So
there was some powerful fighting going on in there.
Hey, I'm 12 years old, about 140, putting up 225 on bench. Yeah, we'll take
225.
It. 225. We'll take it. That's my max.
Really? That's good.
We'll take it.
More than once?
5 times.
Good for you.
It's not bad.
And that performance come out in the cage.
Yeah.
What happened in the second round?
Well, the first round, I hit him with the 1-2, and I just seen him fall back. I tried taking him out in the first round.
I thought you were going to get him.
He got me with the clinch. We don't work clinch all like that, so I didn't really know what to do, honestly. But I got out of it and then tried taking him out, and the bell rang. So
it was close.
Yeah.
Gym do you fight out of?
I fight out of Team Evolution in Butler, PA.
And that's our friend Colleen up
there?
Yeah,
Mama. We call her Mama Evu. Mama Eva.
Mama
dang
Evo.
It.
Yeah, Evo. Well, yeah. We'll shout out to her because she wants us to come up there.
She couldn't make it to the fight.
I know.
Unfortunately.
Why was she hiding out?
What she's telling everyone is her mom, is what happened. Her mom fell and broke her hip, you know. It's a, you know.
I'm sorry to hear
it's
that.
It's a freak accident. Yeah. But apparently she's telling everyone that her mom broke her hip in a cage fight because they were on their way to see me, so.
Yeah.
We're just going to play it like that.
Okay.
Her mom fought for me and didn't go too well, but it's all
right. Right. Well, now, what happened then after you almost won in the first round? I thought it was 19 seconds in the second round.
It was 9. I thought it was 19-2.
Okay. I'm just clarifying
honestly,
it on air.
I went back to the cage, I mean back to my corners, and right. I kind of, because I thought I had him knocked out, so I kind of just used every little bit of energy I had. So I'm coming out in the second round like, you know what I mean? I don't even want to go back out there because I used all my energy, but I got my second win. I honestly did not know why he stopped it anyway because I was in my zone.
You were.
So I didn't know why he stopped it, and then I looked back and they called the fight, so I was like, all right.
You were a little happy then.
Yeah, I was pretty – I was more than happy. I felt like I had a point to prove, you know?
Sure.
Like my first fight, long story short, I had a first cage fight. I lost by decision. Second one, I had a rematch with the guy. I dislocated my elbow in the middle of the fight. It took me almost 2 years to heal from. Had my first fight back in September. I won. I immediately fought in November and lost in 40 seconds. So.
This was a good comeback then.
So, you know, everyone sees John Rarick. He parties a lot, you know.
Right.
I just felt like I had a point to prove. And
I think I made my point. My friend. You more than did it.
I heard a rumor about a title shot, so.
When you find out some more, come on back.
I definitely will.
When do you think you'll be fighting? What's it look like? If this rumor, I heard you're injured. Now tell everybody what happened. Smoke and Jim, he won, right? Listen to what happened.
Well, I kind of got a little excited after I got him stunned. I threw a roundhouse that kind of hit off his elbow, and I didn't really notice that my foot was messed up until after I started getting dressed and I couldn't walk on it. And I'm like, this don't feel right. So I went and seen the doctor, and he's like, you got to go to x-rays. I went and got my x-rays today. They said it's just swollen and bruised. He said you'll be all right. So I think I'm going to fight you in October.
Well,
I'm calling you out in October, by the way.
Smoking Jim Frazier.
Yeah. I'm feeling lucky.
Are you?
Feeling lucky.
Well, you're blessed.
And then you got Dan over there who's got my belt. Kind of won it.
Get on. I can't believe it. Well, you got some incentive. 12-year-old, I can't wait till you're 13. Good luck now.
I might wait till I'm 16.
All right. Well, that'll be October.
Yeah, October in Johnstown, so.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, it sounds great.
I wish
you the
best of luck. Go get some more chicken wings.
You better.
Them chicken wings are all right. I'm telling you.
They are.
Well, you got to go try them.
Try a couple more. Make sure you eat up. And then you don't have to cut weight till October, so you're good.
Yeah.
Right? So. You're going to fight at 140 again?
I'm actually thinking about starting fighting at 135 because there's not really many people in my weight class that are going to be able to just take what I'm bringing. So.
All right.
That's not a threat. That's a promise, guys. But
Mama Eva will be happy to hear this.
Yeah.
On that happy note, John, you take care. How do they get a hold of you? Is there any way they could follow you?
You can find me on Facebook. John Rarick, JonRarick. I got a new phone number, so I don't know my number off by heart.
We'll find out. I'll have to find out.
Yeah, you got to find out for me.
So I want to contact you when you're ready.
All right.
You can come back on the show.
All right, definitely. I will.
You'll do that?
Yeah. After our cage fight. We got to have a cage fight.
Everybody's challenging. He's a lover, not a fighter. Thanks, John.
You're welcome.
You take care. Be
you
safe
too.
Out there. All right. Mario Tempest's friend, he's been putting up on Facebook a bat. Now, Mario Tempest, we had a moment of silence the other day and for his mom, Ann. She's just a great lady. I posted up the first show she was on, and she was on again. We'll post that up also. She passed away the other day, and Mario's here. We appreciate his support. He's a great advertiser. He's a great connector of people here, and he's just not ready to be on TV right now, but we will get him back on air. Definitely. So he brought Jason come in here. Now tell everybody who you are, Jason.
My name is Jason Heffern. I'm actually a founder of a company called Cage Bats. And what we do is we provide wooden bats to the secondary market for you know, players who don't want to spend $115 on a wood bat,
right,
work it a little bit the wrong way, and you know, the thing ends up costing them $35 a swing.
Sure.
So I have, I played in the Cape Cod League. I played on Team USA in college, so
did
I
you?
Have a lot of experience with
wood
bats.
Where are you
from? I'm from just up north.
Where at?
Tarentum.
You can say that.
All right, I want to make sure I
say
that.
Yeah, we're okay.
Yep, from Tarentum.
We're seen all over the greater Pittsburgh area. We're on YouTube 24/7, Verizon 32 in the whole area, Comcast 7 only at Bethel Park.
Good deal.
So you can find us, and we've done over a couple hundred shows, so this will be one of it. So here's your few minutes right
now.
Yeah,
exactly. Mario's been talking to me about the great job you guys have been doing.
Oh,
and
he did.
Yeah, he has been. Jerry Maguire. He's Jerry Maguire.
Hold it, wait. I got a green pen. It's come up again. Here. No, go ahead.
Yeah, but one of the things we're doing is we actually are turning special edition bats, and we do one on a monthly basis. And this one is for the 4th of July. And all the proceeds.
Looks patriotic.
It's very patriotic. They did a hell of a job. I was impressed.
Yes, they did.
And that's the Barry Bonds model.
Oh, yeah.
It's available in 7 different models. But what we
didn't
do.
Didn't he have a black bat?
Yeah, that's just the shape of it.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so the big knob at the bottom.
I've watched baseball.
Yeah, a little bit.
Yeah.
That's what he said.
Not too many are going to stump you on that one.
Not too many.
Okay.
That's true. And what we're doing, though, is with this being the July 4th Independence Edition, all the proceeds, not the profits, literally every dollar generated from the sale of this bat.
100%.
100%.
Okay.
Our woodworking, our mill partner up in Michigan, is who does all of our woodwork for us. We've both gotten together on this project, and all the proceeds and all the revenue generated is going to go straight to the Wounded Warrior Foundation.
Really? Fantastic.
Yeah. So, and we'll be doing
that's
it on a
great
monthly basis.
That's a great group to help, too.
Yeah, and the Special Olympics coming up in September, we'll be doing an addition for them as well. So.
You didn't play much baseball, did you?
He looked like scared of it.
Well, plus the way you see him.
Yeah,
I give you the handle.
Yep, exactly.
You can control it, my friend.
You know, one of the nice things is, you know, typically wood bats cost for a professional grade bat, which this is. I mean, the only difference between this and what Polanco's swinging is there's a cosmetic issue that he didn't like. But
right.
Other than that, it's a fundamentally perfect bat. Now, they typically cost around $100. And what we did is by having such the buying power that we do, we literally can offer a pro-grade bat to an adult player, to a youth player, at $40.
Really? Wow.
Yeah, and when you compare anything.
Hold it, how do they get a hold of you? Put that out right now.
The bats are $40. You get free shipping on 3, which is always a nice thing because bats are heavy. And you can go to cagebats.com, and that's cagebats.com. But I was smart enough to register it with a C. And plural, and misspelled, and every way. So if you just enter Cage Bats, you'll find us.
Excellent.
So
no, you need to do that. Do you have a Facebook page?
Yeah, if you just go on Facebook and search for Cage Bats with a K, you'll find us.
I better like it. I don't know if I liked it.
I think you did.
Yeah, because make sure you like Pittsburgh Sports.
I did, a long time ago when Jerry Maguire first started talking
did
to
you
me.
Really? I better give you an official card.
Yep, there you go. And I will give you a card of mine as well.
There you go.
And we do a lot on Twitter. We give away bat
here,
contracts.
I'll give you a magazine.
Oh, wow, look at that.
So we got everything going on. That's how you network, my friend.
Yep. Networking.
See all that?
That was good. See,
definitely. Not a problem.
And one thing that we are doing is we're going to be awarding a bat contract, like the pros get, to a youth player every month. So if
that's
a youth
awesome.
Player, all you have to do is follow us on Twitter, and that's at Cage Bats.
Of course.
And we'll
Cage Bats is everywhere.
Cage Bats is everywhere.
Even if you misspell it
even
somehow.
Even if you misspell it. It's with a K, but that, you know, don't have to do it that way. But just through our Twitter following. I know. I was doing it wrong myself, and I know it. But yeah, just through our Twitter following, we're going to be giving amateurs bat contracts.
That
so they will
so
never cool. have to buy a wood bat again.
Fantastic.
Pretty
I
fun.
I see this growing and growing.
Yeah, I hope so.
Hopefully we can get the word out.
Well, I'm going to come back. We're going to make you guys your own personal bats.
Are you serious?
Yeah. Yep.
The Al Levine talking machine bat.
Absolutely.
Wow.
We'll be doing that for you guys.
I can't wait.
Yep, looking
Jason,
forward to it.
You're welcome back again.
Let's
talk
it.
About
Thank
that.
You.
We'll have to talk some other time personally and
no
see
problem.
What we can do here.
Absolutely.
Okay?
Pleasure.
Nice Good luck to you.
There. Thank you.
What's up, Juicy Jim? Juicy Jim Frazier in the house, as he was known in the 80s.
Are you serious?
Yeah, man, he had the little Jerry Curl thing going on, man. He was doing his thing over there in God's country.
How do you know this stuff? I thought you guys don't get along.
You introduced me to that private investigator guy.
Ah, yeah.
Hold it. NASCAR Hall of Fame down in Charlotte.
You noticed some key word?
Almost.
And guess who won heavy money on? He wouldn't make it.
Ooh.
There's our man Bob Presson. His pen talking to the telephone.
Well, I'm sure before I arrived late that Jim Frazier had some kind words for LeBron James and the Miami Heat.
No way.
Everybody at home would like a clarification on what heavy money is. Is it just some ones wrapped around a brick? Like,
well, see, I'll tell you, heavy money in my idea is like gold.
Yeah.
Because gold's heavy, and I mean, it's worth like about $1,300 an ounce. So I'm figuring it's about 5 pounds worth.
Don't tell Smoking Jim that. He's going to start popping his fillings out and going to the cash for gold.
There's a place up the street here. I don't know if you saw it, but he don't have any more teeth. All right, what's his heavy money? You want to ask him? I didn't mean to interrupt.
Like I said, the number one question I get asked right now from your adoring fans is, what is heavy money?
Well, I tell you what, it's been a good year, man. A good friend of mine is winning his son, Big Snack, won some national marble shooting contest.
Mr. Puniverse.
Mr. Puniverse. And then I'm a winner because I had the Super Bowl and I had the Spurs in five. And I tell you what, paid no off answer. Real well.
In other words, we won't find out what heavy money is.
Well, we missed Jim Frazier on Saturday night.
People were asking for him. Dan Bogan wanted you out. He was calling you out. I said, no,
he wants to fight
here.
You in the cage.
He wants a piece of you. Hey, we filmed everything. We're behind the scenes all over. Smoking.
You had a camera?
Yeah.
Wow.
We had a guy never did anything for us before. He's the best. No offense to Devin, because Devin's on that soundboard, which we've never gotten information like that without Devin. This guy was all over the ring. Shout out to Mike Mast. He was just fantastic. I actually knew him when he was in the band with my daughter, Casey. He was in the drum line. Yeah.
I didn't know that.
Yeah.
This one time at band camp.
What happened?
Hey, at least I got those guys to laugh. That's what it was for.
I got you.
You got it? Dave Cable, when you edit this, you're going to get a little laugh out of it if you watch any kind of movies.
Exactly.
But wait, let's give a shout out. I know Smoking Jim loves soccer, the real football. Let's give a shout out to USA. They beat your team from Ghana.
Boom!
Ale Boumbaye went down in flames.
Ghana,
team USA,
Ghana's
2-1.
Gone.
Ghana's a Ghana.
Ghana.
They're a Ghana. So it's looking real good for Team USA. Germany. Right behind USA, won over Portugal earlier today.
Hey, and then we missed out on a golfer. I held a spot for our man Aaron. Our man Aaron Gent, and I thought we were going to talk.
I was thinking Smoking Jim Frazier was going to bring up the U.S. Open since Tiger Woods wasn't in it. I'm sure you were riveted by all the honkies.
Hold it. What are you talking about? Something with your car horn or something. We're not in the hood.
Hey, I'm just trying to boost ratings on a basic Monday night.
They're already out. They're already off the charts. We can't get any more. It's growing left
and
right.
What's up, Joyce? I know people miss me on Monday night. I've been coming out just to be a team player. Wink, wink.
Last week, he took one for the team. He knew he wasn't going to be on, and he still showed up.
Late.
What's that matter?
Hey, yeah.
You're going to be late for your own funeral.
He's outside picketing for 15 minutes before the show.
No, he wasn't. These two
what
keep battling.
What a certain hainer.
It's in a sandbox. These guys are fighting, kicking sand everywhere. He wasn't picketing.
Nope.
He's normally late because he followed your lead.
Did he say a certain hater or hainer?
No.
I didn't say hater. I said hainer.
Okay.
You guys have hearing.
I wasn't picketing. I walked through the picket line. I crossed over the line.
Yeah, just to get in here to be with you. And I went like this to him. No, you can't be on. He goes like this. I thought he was smiling when he did it, but he was hitting me in the ribs all Saturday night with that. I kept pointing because I was sore. They wondered why I was pointing at everybody.
Hey, I missed it because that's my favorite place to watch cage fighting is Stage A&E. Yeah.
And we had even better seats than the last time.
Really?
They let us everywhere.
Wow.
You would have loved it.
Wow.
And the door was appropriately placed for you to make your Batman exit before the three best fights of the night.
And we did see.
I had that cleared out for you. I already had your exit strategy planned for you, sir. The car, Alfred was waiting with the car to take you back to God's country.
Hey, before we get too crazy, we got to thank Robert Joseph.
Yeah, we do.
With Gladiators in the Cage. Sam Schmiedel for getting us not one seat, not two. Well, you already know him. He's the big guy.
That's my man.
Three seats, and one was for you. So instead, we had to have Jamie Chesney and John Neder sit next to us.
It's good people. John's
yeah.
Good.
You know who sat next to Jamie Chesney?
Who was that? She sat next to me. You had to sit.
I even mentioned John in the courier.
I know.
You and John.
I know. We appreciate Smoking Jim. Smoking Jim's not allowed to write about us, but somehow he snuck us in. And everybody out there knows what I mean.
I'm being blacklisted just because I'm from Homestead. And my good friend is Charlie Batch. I get no love from the courier.
Well,
I noticed.
The new Pittsburgh
courier. And I like all your stuff, too, when it comes across my news feed.
I like their
page. I read about as many of the articles as Jim writes that he proofreads.
I'll tell you what, a little plug for the courier. I'm watching 42 last night with my nephews. And
Jackie Robinson for you folks at home.
He didn't know that.
Jackie Robinson.
Yeah, Jackie Robinson. And the guy that followed him around was from the Pittsburgh Courier.
Yeah.
True story.
Definitely.
Great
American. They were the biggest paper in the country.
Yeah.
Black paper.
The Black USA Today.
Yeah, they were bigger than that. Definitely. See, I know some history.
Shout out to Jackie Robinson.
And his family.
Hey, how about Chuck Noll?
We are going to get cover that because we're all sports guys.
You guys didn't go over?
No. We're waiting on you.
I was already there yesterday. You can't not pay your respects to the general.
I
Chuck Noll, that's like a grandfather to me.
Emperor. Yeah.
The emperor, well... Yeah. Hey, my generation, we don't forget the great ones. And he paved the way for everything that we know today. We wouldn't even probably have the type of organization that we have today if it wasn't for Chuck Noll. So I'm extremely grateful and thankful for Chuck Noll and the impact he had on the city of Pittsburgh, which has been tremendous. So shout out to Chuck Noll, RIP.
Hold it. And one more thing here, since we do have to show Jim O'Brien wrote the first book.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
On Chuck Noll.
Oh, it's going to sound like hotcakes now.
This is for our man Jim O'Brien, who's the only guest to ever have a whole show.
That's a good show, too.
That was one of our best. He's like Mark Twain when he starts talking. Even out-talk the talking machine.
He did. He handed
him the crown.
He got the title of that.
Go ahead, Smoking Jim, with Chuck Noll.
I was going to say, also a friend of the show, Claudio, knew Chuck Noll to say hi. They lived together in Swickley. In the same community.
And my good family friend Myron Cope lived right next to Chuck Noll for a while in Upper St. Clair.
I never knew that.
Yeah.
2 degrees
small
of
world.
That's it. Somebody heard that. You're learning
RIP
pretty good, young
Tony Pope. Gwynn, too.
Yeah.
Baseball
what
legend.
A great hitter.
Mr. Padre.
I like Tony Gwynn.
I couldn't believe he passed away.
Yeah, he was. And he could hit the ball.
Pete Rose once into the Baseball Hall of Fame.
You're covering everything.
What about Pete Rose?
Oh, we'll talk
about
that.
My favorite player.
Tune in tomorrow night.
Tuesday
favorite
night.
Player.
We get this posted up.
Fast enough.
It might happen.
It might.
Matter of fact, I just heard from Dave Cable. He's almost done with the MMA fights and putting it up.
Wow.
A shout out to Jim Ajay. He watches our show. He's one of our biggest fans in Irwin, PA, or wherever he lives in the country there. He watches every show. He critiques everything we do. So be careful with what you say.
Yeah, because I know in Irwin, PA, they don't get much sports out there. So
well, he's a hunter.
I can see why he's a fan.
He's a hunter and fisherman. You should read his article. You missed it.
Norwin High School, nickname No Win.
Hey, listen, Jim Frazier doesn't even know that he's wearing a New York Knicks hat on. He's so, that's the kind of general studies education you get in God's country.
Hold it. Wait, ladies, how does he look in that? Guys, how does he look?
Juicy Jim. Juicy Jim.
See that? You got more fans smoking Jim and are growing every day. There's no doubt about it. We're almost out of time.
Wrap it up.
Zach Brenner, it's been a pleasure.